Good morning, children. Hope all are doing good. Yeah. In your previous class, what did you learn? You learned about additions, arranging in columns, and you are doing the additions. Now, today's class, we learn about the properties of additions and word problems. Now, properties of additions. We have four properties. We are going to learn four properties of addition. So, what are that? First, addition of 1. So, what is the first property? Addition of 1. On adding 1 to any number, you are getting the successor of the particular number. Suppose, say I have 2346. What is the number I have? 2346. Now, if I add 1 to 2346, what do I get? I get the successor, that is after number. What is the number that comes after 2346? 2347. So, what is the property of addition of 1? When you are adding 1 to any number, you are getting the successor of the particular given number. Okay, then second property, addition of 0. This you know very well. Addition of 0. On adding 0 to any number, you are getting back the same number. Say 9999 plus 0, you are getting back the same number. Got it, children? Addition of 0 is nothing but on adding any number to 0, the answer is the number itself. Next, order property. So, what is your next property? Order property. So, what does that order property say? Order property says, in whichever the order you are adding up, the answer remains the same. Even if you change the order of the numbers, the answer remains same. Say 23 plus 42, what do I get? 50 65. So 23 plus 42 is 65. So what I am doing, it I am adding 42 to 23. Now I am changing the order, that is 42 plus 23 also gives the same number. See, here I am adding 42 to 23, but here I am adding 23 to 42. It means I am changing the order of the numbers here. Even if you change the order of the numbers, the answer remains same. Suppose 2 plus 3 plus 5 is 10. Now if I say 3 plus 2 plus 5 is also 10. 5 plus 2 plus 3 is also 10, right? So what I am doing, I am changing the order of the numbers, but still the answer remains same. That is order property. The next we have last property. What is that? Grouping property of addition. So what does it mean? So in grouping property of addition, we will group the numbers and add. Grouping property of addition. Suppose I have here, say 323 plus 253 plus 72. Say, so grouping, it means I am grouping two numbers using the brackets. So I made it these two numbers under one group, under the brackets. Okay, now let us add this first. 323. So first you have to add the numbers that are in the brackets. First you are going to add the numbers that are in the brackets. 323 plus 253. 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 5. Again to this 576, you have to add 72. 8, 14, 5 plus 1, 6. 648. Listen, children. First, I have grouped these two numbers under the bracket. And you have to add the numbers that are under the brackets 576. Later I have plus 72. So that 72 to this answer I am adding it up now. 6 plus 2, 8. 7 plus 7, 14. 5, carry over 1 here. 1 plus 5, 6. So your answer is 648. Now, the other side. The same numbers. Now the other side. So what I am doing, I am grouping the last two numbers. 253 plus 72. Here, what are the numbers I have grouped it? 323 and 253. And here, I am grouping the last two numbers. So, what did I say? Whatever the numbers are in the brackets, first we have to add those. Now, what are the numbers in the brackets? 253 plus 72. Now, let us add these two. 3 plus 2, 5. 7 plus 5, 12. Carry over 1. 1 plus 2, 3. So, on adding 253 and 72, what are we getting? 325. Now, to this 325, I am adding 323 plus 323. Now, 5 plus 3, 8. 2 plus 2, 4. 3 plus 3, 6. Now, if you compare these two, so what is the answer I got here? 648, 648. Both the answers are same? Yes. It means even in addition, the numbers, even if you are grouping two or more, again you are changing the order, the answer remains the same. That is your grouping property of addition. So, in any way, here what I did, first two numbers I have grouped it, but here the last two numbers I have made it under one group. But still, you are getting the same answer. So, that is the grouping property of addition. Understood, children? What are the four properties we have? Addition of 1, addition of 0, order property and grouping property of addition. Then next, coming to your word problems. Now you have word problems in your term 1 textbook page number 90. So for the word problems, you have to frame the sentences and you have to do it. Now see, you have there, if I read out one word problem, there are 1672 mango trees in an orchard and 1296 trees in another orchard. How many trees are there in the two orchids? So, if you take out your page 90, you have word problem, children. Your first problem, I am reading it up. So, you have to frame the sentences first. Number of mango trees. Now, for the word problem, first sentence, number of mango trees. So, you have to write these statements. So, how many mango trees are there? 1672. Next. You have 1296 trees in another orchard. There are two fields. In one field you have 1672. Number of trees in other orchard. In other orchard. So how many trees are there in the other orchard? 1296. Now you need to check it out. How many trees are there in all? So in all is nothing but addition. So you are going to add up these two numbers. So whatever the final answer you are getting it, those are the total number of trees in both the orchards. So what are you going to write the final statement? Total number of trees. Got it, children? So here you are going to add up these two. Now say 6 plus 2, 8, 9 plus 7, 16, carry over 1. 6 plus 2, 8 plus 1, 9, 1 plus 1, 2. So total, how many trees are there? 2968. So for the word problems, you have to frame the statement and you have to solve the problems in your classwork notebook. Hope you understood the properties of additions and word problems, children. Thank you.